Hi students, good evening to all of you and welcome to my channel. Today's topic is fertilization. Before we have already discussed about that developmental study of that embryo. So in developmental biology, the second event that occurs, that is fertilization. The first event I have already discussed, that is gametogenesis. The gametes are formed first, then gametic fusion takes place. That is why it is the second phase in developmental biology. So, fertilization. Fusion of haploid male gamete with haploid female gamete. Haploid male gamete with haploid female gamete. The process of fusion of a haploid male gamete with a haploid female gamete to form a diploid zygote. ताहले पिले मने ये process रे haploid male gamete हला sperm which contains n number of chromosome. Fused with that haploid female gamete, that is ovum, it is also containing that haploid number or n number of chromosome. So during their fusion, they produces a diploid zygote, which is 2n. So this is zygote, this is ovum, and this is sperm. So fusion, the process of fusion of haploid male gamete and haploid female gamete to form a diploid zygote, that process is called as fertilization, and it is one of the important process in developmental biology. So students, fertilization was first observed by Leeuwenhoek. So pratham observe karthile Leeuwenhoek and give idea about that fertilization, also explains the mechanism of fertilization. So, fertilization always occurs in fluid medium, aquatic medium. As in fluid medium, the lifespan of egg increases. So, it is able to fuse with that sperm. It is become activated in that fluid medium or aquatic medium. If it will be a terrestrial medium, then it reduces the lifespan of that egg. That is why it is mandatory that fertilization occurs in aquatic medium. And for the process of fertilization, two different types of gametes are required. One is male gamete, another is female gamete, but of same species. That is why fertilization is always species specific. Nirdishta species ra sperm sangre, same species ra ovum ra fusion hava to form that zygote, kintu different species ra sperm sangre ovum ra fusion hava nahi, seithi pai kuha jauchi fertilization is always species specific. Fluid medium darkar, same species ra gamete dita darkar, gote male gamete sperm a gote female gamete ovum. So in case of man, fertilization occurs in fallopian tube, and a definite part of that fallopian tube, that is ampullary isthmic region. As you know, the oviduct or fallopian tube is divided into three distinct regions. The part that arises from uterus, that is called as isthmus, and middle wider part is called as ampulla, and fertilization always occurs in that ampulla. So upper side, upper part of ampulla, that is why it is called as ampullary isthmic region. So fertilization occurs in ampullary isthmic region.
पिलमने अबे फर्टिलाइजेशन रो जदि इवेंट गुडी को देखिबा देयर आर फोर डिफरेंट इवेंट्स अकरिंग ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन सेई चारिटा जक इवेंट हैला प्रथम हैला सिनग्यामी फर्स्ट सिनग्यामी पिलमने सिनग्यामी ताकू कहिबा द फ्यूजन ऑफ हैप्लॉइड मेल गैमेट विथ हैप्लॉइड फीमेल गैमेट कंप्लीट फ्यूजन देन द सेकंड वन इज प्लाज्मोगैमी प्लाज्मोगैमी होया द साइटोप्लाज्म ऑफ टू डिफरेंट गैमेट्स गेट मिक्स्ड दैट इज प्लाज्मोगैमी थर्ड वन इज कारियोगैमी नेक्स्ट वन इज कारियोगैमी पिले माने कारियम रो मीनिंग होउछि न्यूक्लियस एवं फ्यूजन ऑफ दैट मेल एंड फीमेल न्यूक्लियस दैट प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज कारियोगैमी एंड लास्ट वन इज एम्फीमिक्सिस होयर द कंप्लीट फ्यूजन ऑफ दैट मेल प्रो न्यूक्लियस एंड फीमेल प्रो न्यूक्लियस टेक्स प्लेस So these are the four events occurs during the process of fertilization. So fertilization can also be explained by its mechanism, which will be later on I will discuss. But first of all, I have to go through detail that types of fertilization. पहले मैंने प्रथम में definition जानी है, को जगह पर fertilization हम चीज जानी है. फर्टिलाइजेशन पे कौन कौन दरकार जानिले सो वर्तमान देखिबा टाइप्स ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ यूनियन ऑफ स्पर्म एंड ओवम ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ साइट ऑफ यूनियन ऑफ स्पर्म एंड ओवम को जगह रे स्पर्म और ओवम रो फ्यूजन होउछ सही अनुसार अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट फर्टिलाइजेशन इज ऑफ टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स वन इज एक्सटर्नल फर्टिलाइजेशन And the second one is internal fertilization. Students, external fertilization taku kahiba when the fusion of that male and female gamete occurs outside the body of individual. Tal individual ra body ra bahar e jodi fusion hela sperm and ovum ra such type of fertilization is called as external fertilization as the fusion of gametes occurs externally. Outside the body of individual and the example of that external fertilization is frog toad fish and all the aquatic invertebrates their fertilization takes place outside the body of individual hence it is called as external fertilization and second one is internal fertilization सो स्टूडेंट्स इंटरनल फर्टिलाइजेशन ताकु कहिबा होयर द फ्यूजन ऑफ गैमेट्स टेक्स प्लेस विद इन द बॉडी ऑफ इंडिविजुअल हियर गैमेटिक फ्यूजन अकर्स विद इन द बॉडी ऑफ इंडिविजुअल टिके पूर्व रूप कहतली जे फालोपियन ट्यूब भीतर मेल और फीमेल गैमेट स्पर्म बा ओवम रो फ्यूजन होछि जायगोट तयार करबा पाए एंड दैट फ्यूजिंग प्रोसेस इज फर्टिलाइजेशन सो When the fusion of that gamete occurs within the body of the individual to form the zygote, such type of fertilization is called as internal fertilization. The fertilization that occurs internally, that occurs inside the body of the individual. So such fertilization is internal fertilization. पिले माने terrestrial animal मानक ठरे देखा जाऊँ थी बा fertilization. It is internal fertilization. एवं टिके पूर्व कहते external fertilization रे एक रा life span decrease करे कमी जाए but in case of internal fertilization it increases the life span of that egg. एवं 12 to 24 hour is the best time for fusion or for fertilization. ताहले पिले बने on the basis of site of union of sperm and ovum फर्टिलाइजेशन इज ऑफ टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स इंटरनल और एक्सटर्नल फर्टिलाइजेशन एवं on the basis of that penetration of number of sperm, keteta sperm एक भीतर को एंटर करुछंती सही अनुसार फर्टिलाइजेशन को मध्य दुई भाग रे विभक्त करा जाय छी गोटे हला मोनोस्पर्मिक फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड सेकंड वन इज पॉलीस्पर्मिक फर्टिलाइजेशन इन मोनोस्पर्मिक फर्टिलाइजेशन ओनली वन स्पर्म एंटर इनटू द एग टू फॉर्म दैट जायगोट आज मेनी स्पर्म्स सराउंड द ओवम एक रा चारिपटे अनेक गुड़िए स्पर्म लागी थिले मध्यो वन इज एबल टू पेनेट्रेट इनटू द ओवम टू फॉर्म द जायगोट फॉर द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन ताहले जदि गोटे मात्र स्पर्म एंटर कला दैट इज कॉल्ड एज मोनोस्पर्मिक फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड द एग्जांपल ऑफ दैट मोनोस्पर्मिक फर्टिलाइजेशन इज फॉर ऑल मैमल्स इंक्लूडिंग मैन frog and man. Then second one is polyspermic fertilization. पहले मैंने polyspermic fertilization तक को कही बात. When more than one sperm enter into the egg to make a fertilized egg. ताले एकाधिक sperm जैसे वाले enter करीब एक भीतर को but only one is able to fuse with that egg nucleus. अनेक गुड़िए स्पर्म एंटर करिवे किंतु ता मध्यर गोटिए मात्र सफल हबो एक न्यूक्लियस संगे फ्यूज होई कि जायगोट तैयारी करिवा पाई सच टाइप ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन इज कॉल्ड एज पॉलीस्पर्मिक फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड द एग्जांपल ऑफ दैट पॉलीस्पर्मिक फर्टिलाइजेशन इज रेप्टाइल्स एंड बर्ड्स सो स्टूडेंट्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ नंबर ऑफ parents involved in the process of fertilization, how many number of parents get involved? According to this, fertilization is also two different types. First one is self-fertilization and cross-fertilization. Pilamane self-fertilization taku kahina. When both the fusing gametes are derived from a single parent, अर्थात गोटे प्यारेंट बॉडी रे जदि मेल गैमेट एवं फीमेल गैमेट दीटे जक तैयारी हला एवं सेमानकर फ्यूजन हे कि जाय गोट तैयारी कला सच टाइप ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन इज कॉल्ड एज सेल्फ फर्टिलाइजेशन बीज बा गोटे बॉडी दीटे जक गैमेट तैयारी कला दैट सेम बॉडी प्रोड्यूसेस द मेल गैमेट स्पर्म एंड दैट सेम बॉडी इज आल्सो प्रोड्यूसिंग दैट फीमेल गैमेट ओवम एंड फ्यूजन टेक्स प्लेस विद इन इट्स बॉडी That process is called as self-fertilization. Fertilization occurs within a single body, within a single individual. It is also otherwise called as uniparental, as only one parent get involved for formation of gametes as well as for the fusion of gametes by the process of fertilization. ताहले पिले वाले अक्वे में कहिबा self-fertilization एवं तार एग्जांपल होउछि टेनिया सोलियम जहाँ को तमे कहउछ फ्लैट वर्म एवं फ्यासियोला हेपाटिका टेनिया सोलियम फ्यासियोला हेपाटिका रिबन वर्म आ फ्लैट वर्म टेनिया सोलियम हला रिबन वर्म एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज क्रॉस फर्टिलाइजेशन पिले माने क्रॉस फर्टिलाइजेशन ताको कहिबा इट इज बाई पेरेंटल आज बोथ द गैमेट्स मेल एंड फीमेल गैमेट्स डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम टू डिफरेंट पेरेंट्स मेल गैमेट स्पर्म गोटे पेरेंट थारु आसीबो एवं फीमेल गैमेट ओवम मध्य अन्य गोटे पेरेंट थारु आसीबो सो हियर द बोथ फ्यूजिंग गैमेट्स आर डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम टू डिफरेंट पेरेंट्स वेयर टू डिफरेंट पेरेंट्स गेट इन्वॉल्वड टू प्रोड्यूस द गैमेट एंड लेटर ऑन देयर फ्यूजन टेक्स प्लेस And that process of fertilization, that type of fertilization is called as cross fertilization. It occurs almost in all mammals. So, in my next session of this video, I will discuss about that mechanism of fertilization. So, students, Here I will discuss about the mechanism of fertilization. ताहले पिले माने वर्तमान में देखिबा mechanism of fertilization. Where is the marker? Mechanism of fertilization. How fertilization occurs? The mechanism of fertilization can be studied by three important headings. The first one is activation of sperm. Second one is activation of ovum. And third one is amphimixis. Amphimixis. Also, I will discuss about the reaction of that cortical granules. What are the physical and chemical changes occurs during the process of fertilization? That I have to discuss. So, in mechanism of fertilization, first one is activation of sperm. As students, you have already known that sperm enter into the female genital tract by insemination. The semen, by carrying the sperm, it enter into the female genital tract, and sperm can live up to 72 hours, but it remain active up to 48 hours for the process of fertilization for penetration into the egg. First of all, the sperm become activated. When the sperm enter into the female genital tract, it reached to that of fallopian tube. When it reached to that of ampullary ischemic region, during that, it releases a secretion that is called as antifertilizer. But prior to it, when egg is released during ovulation into the fallopian tube, fertilization always occurs in the aqueous medium. So oviduct contains some fluid within it. So it is also an aqueous medium. During ovulation, egg released into that fluid medium or aqueous medium of the fallopian tube. When it reached to that of ampulla, तार प्रेजेंस को जड़े ही बा पाई, इट इज सीक्रेट्स ए केमिकल सब्सटेंस फर्टिलाइजर. फर्टिलाइजर कंटेंट्स अमीनो एसिड्स एंड मोनोसैकेराइड्स. सो इट इज ए लार्ज ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन मॉलिक्यूल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एग सीक्रेट्स दैट ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन मॉलिक्यूल फर्टिलाइजर इनटू द सराउंडिंग वाटर एंड बाय मिक्सिंग विथ दैट सराउंडिंग वाटर fertilization, it is called as egg water. So, on approach to that of egg water, sperm secretes that anti-fertilization. And there is a reaction takes place in between that fertilization and anti-fertilization. Pile mane eitai kahi rakhe, sperm release karuthiba chemical substance anti-fertilization, it is a small acid protein. But large glycoprotein is called fertilizer. Anti-fertilizer is a small acid protein. So, the reaction that takes place in between that fertilizer and anti-fertilizer, like that of antigen-antibody reaction. Pilamane jemiti ame janiche, nirdishta antigen and nirdishta antibody sangare, antigen-antibody complex tiyari kariba ba react kariba ba chinhi semiti. Same species of sperm ra antifertilizin, same species of ovum ra fertilizin sangare react karibo. And it can be comparable to that of antigen antibody reaction. So the sperm now approaches towards the ovum. Pilamane not less than 20 million of sperm. 20 million रु कम स्पर्म इज अनेबल टू फर्टिलाइज द एग ताले फर्टिलाइजेशन पावर को इंक्रीज करैबा पाई मोर देन 20 मिलियन ऑफ स्पर्माटोजोआ शुड बी प्रेजेंट एट द एम्पुलरी इस्थेमिक रीजन. so that it facilitates, it enhances the process of fertilization, the chances of fertilization. As you know, fertilization is an accidental process. It occurs by chance. So, the fertilization-antifertilization reaction takes place which bring about sperms to more closure towards the egg membrane. So, many sperms encloses, surrounds that egg membrane, but only one is able to penetrate into the egg cytoplasm. So, out of that 20 million, only one is able to penetrate. ताले कोड़िये मिलियन भीतर गोटिये मात्रा पेनेट्रेट करेगा सही जी मैं हमें आपको कहूँ मोनोस्पर्मिक फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड अदर गेट डीजेनरेटेड अन्य स्पर्म गुड़ा का डीजेनरेट करेगा. सो ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम व्हेन द स्पर्म विल कम इन कॉन्टैक्ट विथ दैट एग मेम्ब्रेन सर्टन चेंजेस अकर्स इन एक्रोजोमल पार्ट ऑफ दैट स्पर्म. स्पर्म रो एक्रोजोमल पार्ट रे किछि परिवर्तन देखाबा. द आउटर लेयर ऑफ एक्रोजोमल एक्रोजोम गेट रप्चर्ड बाय स्पर्म लाइसिन बाय रिलीजिंग स्पर्म लाइसिन. देन द इनर लेयर ऑफ स्पर्म बिकम रिजिड एंड फिलामेंटस सो दैट इट इज कैपेबल टू पेनेट्रेट द एग मेम्ब्रेन. ताले पिले माने आउटर लेयर रप्चर करी गला स्पर्म लाइसिन रिलीज हो गला एवं इनर लेयर ऑफ दैट एक्रोजोमल फिलामेंट बिकम एक्रोजोम रो इनर लेयर टा फिलामेंटस रॉड लाइक हो गला. इट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्रोजोमल फिलामेंट. नाउ इट इज रेडी टू पेनेट्रेट इनटू द एग मेम्ब्रेन बाय रिलीजिंग अनदर एंजाइम दैट इज कॉल्ड एज स्पर्म लाइसिन और हायलुरोनिडेज. The sperm lysin or hyaluronidase help to dissolve the egg membrane. So, the egg membrane allow that sperm to enter into it. The egg cytoplasm ki tarah sperm entry kari jibo by forming a fertilization cone. When it approaches to that of पिले मैंने आउट के मने रखा एक मेम्ब्रेन संग धक्का है व्हिच स्पर्म एट एन एंगल ऑफ 40 डिग्री टू दैट ऑफ एनिमल पोल कोलाइड्स इट विल पेनेट्रेट इनटू द एग मेम्ब्रेन. व्हेन इट कम इन कांटेक्ट विथ दैट जोनल पेलुसिडा फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कोरोनारेडियाटा द आउटर मेम्ब्रेन एंड इट रिलीजेस एन एंजाइम कॉल्ड एज कोरोना पेनेट्रेटिंग एंजाइम. So corona radiata get dissolved, then it come in contact with that zona pellucida by secreting another enzyme zona lysin. It dissolve that zona pellucida, then it will come in contact with that vitelline membrane. When it collides with that vitelline membrane, the egg cytoplasm bulges to form a here the egg cytoplasm bulges to form a cone-like structure that is called as a fertilization cone. And that fertilization cone engulfs the spermatozoa by which the sperm head enter into the egg cytoplasm or ooplasm. So this is all about that sperm activation. And it is get activated by certain by conformation and changes in that acrosomal part. So acrosomal filament is formed. Then activation of ovum. When the sperm engulfed by that fertilization cone, it enter into the egg cytoplasm. पहले मैंने एक एक क्या मैंने रखा जते बेले कोलाइड करूची वाइटेलाइन मेम्ब्रेन संगरे द वाइटेलाइन मेम्ब्रेन एंड द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन गेट थिक एंड टू फॉर्म दैट फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन. ए दीटा तक मेम्ब्रेन कोण करूची थिक एंड मोटा हे जाउची एवं फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन तयारी करूची. पिले माने फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन तयारी करिवार उद्देश्य हला no other sperms can penetrate into it. It prevent the polyspermic fertilization. That is why the fertilization membrane is formed. And during its collision with that vitelline membrane, there certain reactions takes place in cortical granules. The cortical granules secretes certain secretions which separates that plasma membrane and vitelline membrane or fertilization membrane, and there is a space formed that is called as perivitelline space. The perivitelline space towards the animal pole, it contains that first and second polar bodies that formed during the process of oogenesis. पिलामने oogenesis पढ़ीला बेले कुहा इतना जे the secondary oocyte that enter into the fallopian tube, the egg has not matured. So maturation of egg takes place when it enter into the fallopian tube during the process of fertilization. So the secondary oocyte get converted into ovum when the sperm enter into the egg. So sperm by which path penetrate into the egg cytoplasm, that is called as penetration path. जो बाट देख penetrate कला ताकु कुहा कला penetration path. The first path taken by the sperm to enter into the egg cytoplasm, that is called as penetration path. Then the second path taken by the sperm to approach the egg nucleus, that is called as copulation path. That path taken by the sperm to approach the egg nucleus called as copulation path. फिर मैंने first path का है लक्षण penetration path, sperm enter करा एक रस cytoplasm भीतर को, एवं second path है ला copulation path by which the sperm at a random approaches towards the egg nucleus. During this, the sperm nucleus enlarges by acquiring more fluid from the more water from the egg cytoplasm. ताहले sperm nucleus बड़ा है गला observe कला water egg रस cytoplasm and it is termed as male pronucleus. And at the same time, the female nucleus is also absorbing certain amount of water from its cytoplasm and get enlarged to form that female pronucleus. पिलियावरे तापुर्वर्टी के बुझी दिया, the second meiotic division completed on approach of that sperm. Sperm enter कला परे, sperm head contains that proximal centriole. And the proximal centriole initiates the second meiotic division, and the secondary oocyte then get converted into a matured ovum. पहले मैंने cortical granule तो Golgi complex का content है, वो cortical granule गुड़ी का रहा reaction करा रहे perivitelline space form है ना, जहाँ भीतर polar body गुड़ी करा है, ये वो एक समय भीतर एक nucleus that is called as female pronucleus and male pronucleus. They get fused together by the process of amphimixis, the complete fusion of male pronucleus and female pronucleus takes place to form a zygotic nucleus. So the zygotic nucleus is formed and the structure is called as zygote. So by this way, the mechanism of fertilization takes place to form that zygote by union of haploid male gamete and haploid female gamete, so that zygote is formed with definite polarity. Towards that polar body, where polar body and nucleus is present, that part, that pole is called as animal pole. And the opposite to that of animal pole, it is called as vegetal pole. Now the zygote is formed. So students,
In my next session of this video, I will discuss about significance of fertilization and some important questions that have already come in NEET examination that will be given in this video. So students, let us come to the significance of fertilization. Fertilization ra kon significance ba vaishishta rahichi. As fertilization is the complete fusion of that the process of fusion of haploid male and female gamete to form the zygote. So it restores the diploid stage of zygote. Gamete gudak haploid heithibaru dita haploid gamete misiki gote diploid zygote tiyari karuchi tenu ए जो डिप्लॉयड नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम मेंटेन जनरेशन आफ्टर जनरेशन सो इट रिस्टोर्स द डिप्लॉयड स्टेज ऑफ जायगोट जायगोट का सेट में डिप्लॉयड हो छि इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दैट प्रोक्सिमल सेंट्रीओल फ्रॉम स्पर्म टू ओवम सेति पई कहितले जे स्पर्म न्यूक्लियस जते बेले अप्रोच करू छि एक न्यूक्लियस को अलोंग विथ दैट प्रोक्सिमल सेंट्रीओल इट रोटेट ऑन एंगल ऑफ 180 डिग्री सो दैट the centriole will introduced into the ovum as a centriole remain present in between these male and female pronucleus activation it activate the egg to produce secondary oocyte to become a matured ovum tale egg ko activation karuchi fertilization hoba jo tale secondary oocyte get converted into matured ovum इट मेक्स एग फ्रुटफुल आ पूर्व सेकेंडरी ओसाइट हेतिला ताकु ये कोन कला मैच्योर करेला सो इट मेक्स एग फ्रुटफुल एंड इनिशिएटिंग फर्दर डेवलपमेंट नेक्स्ट डेवलपमेंट होची क्लीवेज तल क्लीवेज को इनिशिएशन करूची बाय इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दैट प्रोक्सिमल सेंट्रीओल फर्टिलाइजेशन मेम्ब्रेन प्रिवेंट स्पर्म पॉलीस्पर्मी ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन आज There is a thick membrane formed by fusion of that plasma membrane and vitelline membrane. It prevent further entry of spermatozoa. Then polyspermic fertilization by polyspermy ye prevent karuchi. It enhances the metabolic rate of zygote. Zygote ra metabolic rate ko increase karuchi. It determines the sex of embryo. Ekhi pai kuha jauchi embryo ra sex ko determine karuchi boli. Mane kara The sperm containing X chromosome fuses with that ovum. Definitely, ovum has that X chromosome, the female sex chromosome. Then the resultant zygote is a female. As it contains XX chromosome. So here it determines whether the offspring will be a male or a female. Finally, the next chance is. Y chromosome containing sperm when fused with that egg it form a male offspring. So it determines the sex of embryo whether it will be male or female. And a combination of a different gametic materials, sperm derived from that father and ovum from mother. So by fusion of that two different genetic material derived from two different parents. It is bring about variation in offspring. So variable offsprings are formed. So students, in next session of this video, I will give five important questions regarding that fertilization. So students, I am going to that question session. In question session. The first question is coronalidin dissolved by DAS enzyme secreted from acrosomal part of sperm. And the second question is fertilization occurs in DAS of oviduct. Oviduct ko jagar fertilization hue. Very simple questions. Fertilizing plus surrounding water. It is formed DAS. It is so called DAS. And the fourth question is the path taken by the sperm to penetrate into the egg cytoplasm is called as DAS. And last but not least, polar bodies are located in which part of the egg? So these questions are very
simple questions and these questions are also well described in this video. So students, this is all about that process of fertilization, mechanism of fertilization, events of fertilization and significance of fertilization. So if you like my video, then subscribe my channel. Thanking you.